The Eden Interstate Challenge is one of Australia's most coveted spearfishing competitions. It is attended by divers from all over Australia, and it is not uncommon to host over 100 competitors. Each competitor has their own comp story to tell. This is ours. Initially, the forecast leading up to the comp wasn't looking too good. The midweek update, however, showed a break in the weather, and Jess and I decided to make the 6-hour drive south from Sydney. We packed the car on Thursday night and left straight after work on Friday.
What have you done, Michael? What's going on?
What do you mean, what have I done?
I thought we were going for a little comp dive.
Well, it started that way. Rock hopping the Eden 3-way state championship. But there's Marlon there too. So, through Takash form, I'm packing everything. We're knocked off work now, it's just 20 past 3. You can see the traffic in the background's already banking up. It's going to be a nightmare to get out of Sydney, but
worth it.
That's the joy of living in Sydney.
Had a booking for tonight. We're not gonna be getting there until about 11. Is there gonna be someone there to let us in, or do you leave keys out or something?
Definitely makes all the difference with the work, doesn't it?
So I can't wait to get down to Eden. It's been a few years since we've been there, but it's a pretty special place. Just the sound. I love the sound when you get there and you got the bellbirds here, yeah, fucking awesome.
Just and sounds, I'm just excited for the seafood.
Lobster,
abalone, mussels.
Lobster, abs, mussels.
Squid, I think
bories. I can't wait to do a long snout bory print.
And they taste amazing as well.
Barrier reef of the south, I reckon. You dive down and there's just 6 or 7 different species to choose from. You think, fuck.
It's like an aquarium, it's always clear as well.
Not always clear, but it's
pretty good.
A really special place, I can't wait. Tractor beam, sucked us in yet again.
So it's 6 in the morning, we got in late last night, about 11:30, rigged a bit of gear, in bed by midnight. I didn't sleep much, I was pretty excited.
We can tell you didn't sleep.
Do I look pretty
Your
tired?
Your eyes are so baggy.
I haven't been kept up at night from being too excited from a comp for a long time, so I think it's a bit of a sign of what the day is about to be like. I'm just gonna go down, sign on, and then, get into it.
Exit the roundabout onto Mitchell Street.
Secret to an easy wetsuit donning, born flat.
Thank you. these days. I wish you all good luck. Don't push yourselves too hard. Don't take any crazy risks. But have a safe day and hopefully a successful day.
Thank you. Cheers.
With the briefing out of the way, we were off. With a 9 o'clock high tide, our plan of attack was to race up to Maroombula Lake and try to pick up a few oddball species such as flathead, flounder, whiting and a big brim.
Ready to smash it, Michael?
Oh, boy.
How
are
you feeling?
Good, excited. It's so nice driving to the dive spot without the cold air on. You've got the heater on, my feet are warm.
It's 10 degrees right now on the
it's probably about 35 degrees in here.
Freezing. My hands are warm, I can't complain.
The aim of the competition is to obtain one of each species from a very selective list. The fish are scored in relation to their maximum size. For example, a leather jacket that only grows to about a kilo is on A scale and receives 80 points per kilo, whereas a large fish such as a kingfish is on F scale and will receive 5 points per kilo. The maximum points you can earn is 150 for any one fish. We arrived at the lake, jumped in, and were greeted with a brisk 12 degrees.
These gloves, they do nothing!
It's frickin' freezing in here, Mr. Bigglesworth.
Oh, fuck, ice cream headache.
We just had to wait for our faces to go numb, and then it was all good. It seems the fish didn't like that temperature either, as they were nowhere to be seen. The lake was dead.
Dead? Swim in.
This octopus was even sprawled out on the sand, trying to soak up some of the sun. After an hour with only one lutterick, we decided to bail on the lake and head to Leonard's Island to see out the remainder of the 6-hour competition. We got back in the car, cranked the heater and drove to Leonard's Island. Jess was so cold she forgot to turn the microphone on, which wasn't all bad as we were just complaining about the temperature and the lack of fish.
Okay. Just headed to the next dive spot. It's a four-wheel drive track, about 4Ks. We're going to spend the rest of the comp there. Hopefully, not too many people diving there already.
Hopefully there's some fish there.
Yeah, we gave up over an hour with the Maroombula Lake. So, hopefully this will be
redemption,
our saving grace.
It's weird, isn't it? Someone's down there.
We arrived at Leonard's Island, geared up, and raced down the trail.
Oh no, I've got troubles in my mind, and the doctor's scared.
The conditions were nothing short of spectacular. 25 meters visibility and a balmy 17 degrees. Just waiting patiently to commit their crime. Dangerous happiness, that is what I want to take. The first fish we came across were deep body leather jackets, one of the easiest fish to clean and are also delicious when pan fried whole. This cave was loaded with moong. Jesse picked herself up a nice blue and I got myself a bandit. Moong's are great steamed with ginger and shallots.
Kinging.
You did?
Just
here.
At one stage, a school of big kingfish came in to check me out, but unfortunately, in the clear water, they stayed well out of range. Trying to make up for lost time in the lake, I decided to take two species with one shot.
Bluethroat wrasse has a healthy population on the New South Wales south coast. Their delicate white flesh makes them a prized table fish. Before we knew it, our time was up. It was a quick scramble up the path back to the car. Jess encountered some technical difficulties on the way up. It was time to line up for the weigh-in and see how everyone had gone. A great selection of fish had come in. It was going to be interesting to see who came out on top.
Jess's and mine, yeah. Yeah, all the dirt.
Jess was first to weigh in her fish, I followed shortly after.
Four birdies.
I think
20. 920. There's a trumpeter. 17.95.
After the weigh-in, everyone heads down to the filleting tables to clean their catch. All the South Coast species are really good eating. The pelicans, seagulls, and giant stingrays take advantage of all the scraps. Nothing goes to waste. In the background, the scores were tallied up and the presentation was set for the following night.
I think I remember rightly there were... Third place in rock hoppers is Michael Takesh.
So tonight I'm going to cook up some of the drummer that we shot in Eden. I'm going to cook a Thai green curry, super simple but delicious and really easy to cook. Basically, I use about half a jar of green curry paste. So in here, I've fried up the curry paste and added in the coconut milk and just brought it to a low simmer. Add in the cubes of fish and cherry tomatoes and some frozen peas and serve it with rice. Really simple.
Before we knew it, another successful Eden interstate competition had come to an end. Congratulations to all who competed and a huge thank you to all the organisers for their hard work. Being able to compete along such a rich coastline really makes you appreciate the healthy fishery we have here in Australia. Until next time, thanks for watching and I hope to see you on the next Underwater Ally adventure.